Ah, what a beautiful day for pasting again. And you know what? I think I'm not gonna be a script kiddie anymore. Yeah, I'll start by learning networking. How to start networking. Okay, let's go in video. All right, wait, what? How to stop having AIDS? Buy my $10,000 networking course. What the hell are these things? How am I supposed to learn networking from that?
Well, здравствуйте, and sorry for that cringe sketch, it was just me trying to be funny. In my last video, I explained how you can get started with game hacking. I briefly mentioned networking and thought, why not make a video dedicated to it as well? Networking is really useful because you can do like the good old days and pop your alpha network card on the side of the window and start cracking your neighbor's Wi-Fi password. And as a disclaimer, doing that without authorization is completely illegal, so don't do it. A network packet is basically a file containing bytes of information about the device sending it and is most often accompanied by some raw data. You can view them by using a lead hacker tool like Wireshark. Anyway, so packets can be divided in simple levels or layers. Now, the first layer will be the link layer. The link layer is used to connect your device to other devices. In packets, it contains something called a MAC address, but don't be mistaken. The MAC address is only used in your local network to identify your network card. And this MAC address is static, though it is possible to change it using software. The first 3 bytes of that MAC address identifies your manufacturer, and the last 3 bytes only identifies your MAC address on the network and is pretty much random. After that, the next layer is called the internet layer. The internet layer is where you find what people call IPs or internet protocol. It is used to identify your device on a local network but also on the public network. There are 2 versions of the internet protocol, the IPv4 and the IPv6. IPv4 is almost always used in local networks, but is slowly being overlaid by IPv6 on the public side because of its size limitations, which is only 32 bits, which allows for 2 to the 32 possible numbers, or this big number of possibilities. While IPv6 is 64 bits, which allows for 2 to the 64 possible numbers, or this big number. Now, just to set a clear terminology, this local network I keep referring to is what we call a LAN, or local area network, and the public is WAN, or wide area network. Now, there's a bunch of other words which are context-based, but I don't consider them as relevant for this video. So you might have understood already that all your devices on the LAN have an IPv4, but don't have one publicly. In order for a server, for example, to respond with something to your device, your router will basically look up inside of a table and respond to your device accordingly. Now, the specific protocol that is used to do this is called NAT, or Network Address Translation Protocol. The next layer is the transportation layer, in which you find 2 main protocols, the TCP or Transport Control Protocol and the UDP or User Datagram Protocol. The main difference between TCP and UDP is their reliability. TCP establishes a connection between the 2 hosts using what we call a handshake, and if established, proceeds to communicate all the while checking if the packets were correctly received, while UDP does not perform any handshake or checks of such. While TCP is more reliable than UDP, it is considerably slower. That is why UDP is most commonly used in games, while TCP for chats. But do keep in mind that there are other protocols than TCP and UDP in transportation. You could even invent your own. And finally, there is the application layer. On the application layer is where you find all the neat protocols like HTTP. This layer is the part that allows the logic of most applications, thus its name. HTTP, for instance, is used to fetch documents like HTML and has multiple standards. It returns a response called like that 404 you get on websites when the resource is not found, and can be used to do different things depending on the method that is used, like get to get resources, post to send data to, for example, a login backend, delete to query the deletion of certain data, and finally update to update some data. Here's just a couple of them for instance. The only advice I can give you if you want to learn most of them is just look up when you find a new one, because really it's useless to learn all of them by heart. Just learn them when you need them and you'll be fine by just reading a Wikipedia page on the new protocol you discovered. Now, this model I presented to you is a lot like the OSI model but very simplified, and you could call it the TCP/IP model. Now, if I just presented to you the OSI model, the video will have just been longer and for no reason, since I would have just talked about a lot of more protocols that you would have learned on your own. The goal of this video was really just to establish basics that you can use to learn and know what to expect in the future when it comes to networking. Shout out to La Sorpresa de la Mula for supporting me on my Patreon, and thanks to all the others too. If you join my Patreon now, you will get exclusive access to code and also videos. It is already the end of this video, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.